Hello, beautiful blockchain people. That's me again at CryptoSpine. This is my next cryptocurrency market overview. So let's start. Let's have a look at the prices of the major cryptocurrencies according to the site of CoinGecko. And as we see, most of the major cryptocurrencies have recorded slight or small price decline for the last 24 hours. But in general, I would say that the uptrend renewal continues in the price charts of most of the major cryptocurrencies. And today I will analyze the price chart of Ethereum because yesterday we started with Bitcoin. Its current price is $3,492. So let's move on to the price chart of Ethereum. Of course, we will start from the monthly time frame, but initially let me remove the unnecessary elements from the price chart. And this is the price chart. Here the price is $3,480. We know that Ethereum experienced, like most of the major cryptocurrencies, solid price increase in the first couple of months of the year. After that, in May, a long leg doji formed, a candlestick signaling some kind of indecision. Then a small correction took place. At the bottom of this correction, a hammer formed. So we commented on this candlestick, a common trend reversal candlestick, and after that, the price has started to increase. Actually, in the next month, in August, we had this solid bullish candlestick. In September, we had this candlestick with a bearish body, but I highlighted that it has a local high above the previous ones and a local low above the previous ones, so that was a small bullish and neutral signal. And now we're entering the second half, the second third of the month, and we have this bullish candlestick. Of course, this candlestick may change till the end of the month, there is enough time. But if we assume that at the end of the month we have something like this, then this will be a bullish signal because we have a bullish candlestick completely covering the body of the bearish one. So once again, this is a small bullish signal if confirmed at the end of the month. Now let's move on to the weekly chart. So this is the weekly chart. This is the solid price increase that took place earlier this year, followed by a correction. At the bottom of this correction, we had a bullish engulfing. Here we had another one. Then the common trend reversal or bullish candlestick formation called three white soldiers. Then the price hit the previous local high. So we've been talking about this many, many times. So this high is at the level of this one. And the bulls face resistance. The price declined. At the bottom of this decline, a bullish engulfing took place. I commented on it last week. And after the bullish engulfing, we have a small doji. This doji indicates that the market has entered some kind of period, let's say some period of indecision or consolidation. Probably we will see some kind of consolidation in the near future, but because we had this bullish engulfing here, probably the price will try to increase once again, to start to increase once again and hit this local highs. It's just a matter of time in my view, but we have to be really also very careful because after the bullish engulfing, we have some kind of break or period of indecision. Now let's move on to the daily chart. This is the daily chart. This is the all-time high. This is the previous local high. We are here below this local high and below this one. But let me remind you that we've been talking about this ascending channel or uptrend. And it's obvious that after consolidating or testing the lower line of this ascending channel, the price has started to increase once again. So I think that the price will continue its journey within this ascending channel, and it's probably just a matter of time when we will reach the level of the previous local highs. This is at least in my view. Now let's move on to the 4-hour chart because we have an interesting technical or technical pattern or formation as well, and we've been talking about it many, many times as well. So this is the 4-hour chart. First of all, let me remind you, we had a double bottom here. So this is the left bottom, this is the right bottom. So that is a common trend reversal candlestick that usually occurs at the end of a bear market. So obviously, it was a valid one because the price has started to increase. So this is actually the price increase, but later approaching the levels of this local high or entering the range of this local high, the price once again has the bulls has faced resistance and the price has experienced a decline. So this is the decline. We have here a bullish flag or some kind of descending channel or wedge forming this bullish flag. But we know that this is a common trend continuation pattern, and it's obvious that the price has exited the bullish flag and now the price is resuming the uptrend, and slowly but steadily the price is increasing, and now we're testing this local high. After that, probably we will start to test this local high. So the price has exited the bullish flag, and probably it's highly probable that the price will continue its journey in the upward direction. This is in my view. So it seems that in most of the major time frames we have bullish signals. So I'm bullish on the price chart of Ethereum. Of course, we also have to be really very careful, because if the volatility increases and all of a sudden a bearish pressure pops up, we may see some kind of, let's say, further correction, let's say, or once again we can see some correction, but definitely probably the uptrend will resume, even if we experience in the near future some kind of correction. So that's it for today, fellas. Thank you for watching this video. Please share your point of view on the price chart of Ethereum as a comment below. Of course, I wish you a very wonderful day, good luck in the financial markets, and I hope to see you in the next one. It was me again at CryptoSpark.